A very warm welcome to all you beautiful students to India's largest online learning platform, Unacademy. The chapter that we are going to discuss today is The Monkey and the Crocodile, and this is chapter 6 from your book Honeycomb. Before we start, let me tell you something about myself. Dear learners, my name is Sweksha Sahai and I am your English educator at Unacademy. I have many years of experience in the field of teaching and especially in teaching English. I am extremely passionate about learning and teaching languages. Apart from English, I know two other languages, which are French and Spanish. So that was a little bit about me. And you can always ace your school with Unacademy. And now you are also going to get the Unacademy's Plus subscription at a flat 10% discount if you use my code SWS10. So what are we waiting for? Go for it today. And if you have not downloaded the app, you must, because the app is amazing. It has got so many benefits. You can ask a doubt, you can learn about so many things, you can unlock new tests and so much more. So go ahead and get the app today and unlock all the benefits that you can with my code SWS10. And with that, let's begin with our chapter, The Monkey and the Crocodile. This chapter is called. So this is a very interesting story from Panchtantra. The books that contain stories, small stories with a lot of wisdom in them. So this is an adaptation of one of the stories from this book called Panchtantra. It's a great book for children of your age. So with that, let's begin. So once on the bank of a river, a monkey made a home for himself in a tree laden with fruit. He lived in it happily, eating to his heart's content the fruit of his choice. So the first paragraph said that once upon a time there was a monkey who found home in a tree. The tree was always laden with fruit and the monkey had a gala time eating all the fruits from the tree. The monkey was happy but lonely and wanted a companion to talk to and share the fruits with. But there was no one around, not even another monkey, till one day a crocodile appeared on the riverside. So this monkey, even though he was content with all the food that he was getting, he was not really happy. Because tell me, for how long will food make you happy? You do need friends, right? So what happened was, this monkey was not really happy, and then who came along? A crocodile. So this crocodile came along, and the crocodile and the monkey became friends. So let's see how they became friends. Hello there, said the monkey. Do you live in this river? Why do you would you like to eat some fruit? So when the crocodile came along, the monkey started socializing with him. He said, hello, hi, do you live in this river? And he offered some food to the crocodile. Good morning, replied the crocodile politely. I did come here in search of food for myself and my wife. Nice of you to offer me fruit. So the crocodile was pleased with the fact that monkey offered him fruits. The monkey plucked some fruits from the nearest branch and threw them down. The crocodile found them delicious. Thanks, he said. May I have some on my next visit? Certainly, as many as you like, and some for your wife too, said the monkey. The monkey was generous and a nice person, so he also offered some fruits for the crocodile's wife. Do come again, I'm rather lonely here. And the monkey also invited him to come back because he felt lonely alone. The crocodile visited the monkey regularly and ate fruits which his host threw down. He took some home for his wife. The monkey and the crocodile were now the best friends. They talked and were never tired of talking. They talked about birds and animals, about the villages nearby and the difficulties villagers faced in raising good crops for the lack of rain. So these were some things that the crocodile and the monkey used to talk about. So basically they used to talk about everything that normal people talk about the environment, about other beings of society, about what are the problems that people are facing. So they were just like two normal friends hanging out together. One day, the crocodile stayed with the monkey longer than usual. So what happens one day? The crocodile stayed with the monkey for longer than usual. His wife was annoyed, waiting and waiting, managing the little crocodiles that had just been hatched. She said, "Who is this friend of yours you are so fond of?" So to be fond of someone means to like someone a lot. So this lady crocodile, she was very curious about the crocodile's new friend. And she was like, "Who is this friend who you are very fond of, whom you like a lot?" "Oh, he is a very nice monkey," he replied. "He lives on a fruit tree. He sends fruits for you every day. You don't expect me to climb trees, do you?" So now the crocodile used to bring fruits for the wife every day. So now he told the secret, like who used to give the tree. Of course, the crocodile was not climbing the tree to get them. "A nice monkey, I'm sure," she replied with obvious sarcasm. "If you ask me, this monkey should be my food. I want to eat his heart so much." So this lady crocodile, she was not as good as the crocodile himself. She was a little crooked and she wanted the monkey's heart. "What a foolish thing to say," shouted the crocodile. "I can't kill a friend, though I won't mind a monkey occasionally for a change of taste." See, at the end of the day, a crocodile and monkey can never be friend, because a monkey is an obvious food of a crocodile. And this is exactly what happens in this story. So this crocodile himself admits that he wouldn't mind a monkey for a meal sometimes. "What a foolish thing to say," shouted the crocodile. "I can't kill a friend, though I won't mind a monkey occasionally for a change of taste." "You bring him here," ordered the wife. "I want to see him, so you can eat him." "Never," declared her husband. His wife was furious and she dived in to hide herself at the bottom of the river, leaving the little ones to pester their father. To pester means to annoy, okay? So if you want to write the meaning of this word, you can write this down. To pester means to annoy. P-E-S-T-E-R. And the meaning is to annoy someone or to constantly nag someone. Like how kids do, they ask repeatedly the same question or they ask for so many things. That is pestering. Okay. The crocodile was in a serious dilemma. He loved his wife and was very fond of his friend too. Finally, he decided to be on the side of his wife. She was his life partner after all. "I know this is a sin to betray a friend, but I have no choice," he said to himself. "I'll invite the monkey home and hope for the best." "My wife wants you to come over for a meal, dear friend," said the crocodile when he visited the monkey next. "You must come home with me today." So crocodile, he goes to the monkey and talks about his wife's desire to call the monkey home. And monkey, who was a nice person, he believed the crocodile that, okay, the crocodile's wife, whom he sends fruits for every day, may want to meet him. So he got on the crocodile's back and decided to swim. "So with pleasure," said the monkey. "I am no swimmer, but can ride on your back." And they set out. In the middle of the river, where the current was strongest, the crocodile could no longer hide his intention. So in the middle of the river, what happens? The current of water. You know, now when the water is flowing, it has a current, okay? And in the mid-river, this current is the strongest. So in mid-river, this crocodile reveals that, "Dear friend, my wife wants to eat you," okay? In the mid-current, where will the monkey go? Because monkeys don't know how to swim. That's obvious. So then what happens? Let's see what the monkey does. In the middle of the river, where the current was the strongest, the crocodile could no longer hide his intention. "Sorry, my friend," he said hesitatingly, "but I have to go underwater now. I have brought you here to kill you. My wife cannot survive without eating your heart. So goodbye." The monkey was scared and distressed, but he was sensible and clever like all monkeys. So anybody would be scared if a crocodile says that, "I want to eat you," or "My wife wants to eat your heart." And the monkey was in a lot of stress as well, but he was a clever guy, because all the monkeys are clever. He kept a cool head. Calmly, he said, "I do anything for you and your family. You are my only friend. After all, What is a monkey's heart compared with the life of a crocodile's wife? But how foolish could you be? Why didn't you tell me before? I'd have brought my heart along. So now the monkey plays a little game with the crocodile. He says that, there is no problem, my friend. I would happily give my heart for the happiness of your wife. But you should have told this to me earlier. You should have revealed this intention earlier, because I am not carrying my heart. So he plays a little trick over here. But where is your heart? Asked the crocodile innocently. I thought you were carrying, you carried it all the time. Of course not. It is there on the tree. Let's swim back once and get it. Your wife must be waiting, replied the monkey, gaining confidence. Oh dear, what a mistake, hissed the crocodile. They laughed loudly as the crocodile took a full turn to reach the tree. On the riverbank, the monkey jumped to the tree and heaved a deep sigh of relief. So, फिर क्या होता है कि, of course, we know from the story that the monkey tricked the crocodile into taking him back to the tree. And once he gets to the tree, he takes a deep sigh. Okay? A sigh is when you breathe deeply. Okay? A deep sigh of relief. He plucked a fruit or two from the nearest branch, throwing them down, said, let your wife have some fruit rather than my heart. Fresh fruits are good for the mind and body. Goodbye, friend, and if you don't mind, we won't meet again. The crocodile, sadder and wiser, shed a few tears, which were genuine, and turned back to go home. He was in a hurry to tell his wife a thing or two. So, there is an imagery used over here that the crocodile shed genuine tears. Now, what happens is, there is a famous thing called, phrase called shedding crocodile's tear. What happens whenever a crocodile yawns, it opens its mouth so wide that tears come out of his eyes. But those are not real tears. They only come out because the crocodile is yawning. So it's exactly this phrase which is mentioned over here, that the crocodile this time shed genuine tears. And he was in a hurry to tell his wife a thing or two, which means they would go home and probably have an argument. So this is the end of story, and this is an adaptation from the story from the Panchtantra. Okay, now let's move on to the question answers of this chapter. The first question is, the monkey was happy living in the fruit tree, but his happiness was not complete. What did he miss? So the answer is on the very first page, and that says, the monkey was happy living in the fruit tree, but he missed having a companion to talk to. And we see that in the first chapter, that he was very happily eating the fruits, but he did not have no one to talk to, and he missed having a friend. What did the two friends generally talk about? So it's talking about the monkey and the crocodile. And the two friends generally talked about other animals and birds. They also talked about problems in the nearby villages. Why was the crocodile's wife angry with her husband one day? So the crocodile's wife was angry with him one day because he had stayed longer with the monkey, and she was tired of managing her newborn children all by herself. So we see that his wife gets annoyed because he had stayed longer with the monkey. Why was the crocodile not willing to invite his friend home? The crocodile was not willing to invite his friend home because he knew that his wife will eat his friend. He knew about his wife's intention, and that is why he did not want to invite the friend home. What did the crocodile tell the monkey midstream? The crocodile told the monkey midstream that he was taking him home because his wife wanted to eat his heart. We remember that the crocodile revealed his intentions midstream to the monkey. How did the monkey save himself? Now, this is actually the entire story. The monkey saved himself by using his wisdom. When the crocodile told the monkey that his wife wanted to eat his heart, the monkey told him that he would happily offer his heart to keep his friend's wife happy, but he was not carrying his heart and they will have to go back to pick it up. The crocodile believed him and took him back to the tree. And then we all know what happened. The monkey never came down. What does the last sentence of the story suggest? What would the crocodile tell his wife? The last sentence of the story suggests that the crocodile was disappointed on losing a good friend because of his wife's selfishness, and he would go back home and scold his wife. So we can see that the moral of the story is that there are so many things that we can derive from the story. First of all, we should not just make friends with anybody in desperation. A monkey and a crocodile can never be friends. But I think the monkey was really desperate and he made friends with a crocodile. The second thing is that we should never betray a friend, because if we betray a friend, we would always end up losing them. And of course, we should always use our wisdom and stay calm and cool in a situation of distress. So all these three things is something we can derive and learn from this particular story. Well, that brings us to the end of this chapter, but you can always get the Unacademy's Plus subscription. The features are listed on the screen. You get to learn live from the comfort of your home. The top educators from all over the country are teaching you live. There's an unlimited access to all the courses, regular doubt clearing and answer writing sessions, exhaustive coverage of the entire syllabus. Mentorship and guidance is available, of course. You also get study material in PDF format. There are practice tests, live test series, and batch courses. So these are all the benefits that you get once you get the Plus subscription. The pricing for the Plus subscription is right now on your screen. So you can see the pricing and you can also see my code, which is SWS10. If you use this code, you can get a flat 10% discount on all the prices which are available on the screen. Also, we have the amazing iconic subscription, and you get all the benefits of the Plus subscription, and then there are more benefits, which are personal mentorship, which means you're assigned a personal mentor who will help you with your development. There's live doubt solving, which means you get the answer to all your doubts right away. You don't have to wait. There's weekly report and parent connect, which means your parents get to know about your development during the week. There's study planner and all the other benefits of the Plus subscription. And the pricing for the Unacademy's iconic subscription is on the screen right now, so you must go for it, and you can use my code SWS10 to get a flat 10% discount on this amazing subscription. Well, that brings us to the end of this session, but I will be back again tomorrow with the next chapter. And until then, do like, share and subscribe to this channel. Also press the bell icon so that you never ever miss any other chapters from your books. And that is all from me for today, but I will catch you very, very soon. So thanks a lot for watching and have a great day ahead. Bye bye guys.